It's not on mute. Good evening, everyone. I'm so happy to see all of us here to support our children. This is my second one of these year-end gathering, and I remember last year it was extraordinary. And I believe this year it's going to be even better. Amen? And so I'm happy to have all of us here. And this evening you're going to see your children in action. You're going to see what they have learned and the gifts that God has given them. And so I applaud you for being here to be a part of this event in their lives. And so I'm going to do something a little different. This is all about what God has done for the children. I'm going to invite everyone to stand. And we are about to say a word of prayer. Mello, he loves to pray. Would you like to give a prayer for us? Yes, all right, come forward. I'd like you to bow your heads as we pray to open this evening's program.
Lord, please help us as we go through life. Please help us obey our parents. Please help the children do good on the program. Please help us as we sing through the program. Please help us as we go through life. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Praise God. Please be seated.
Okay, it's my joy to welcome each of you out tonight. It is a joy and a privilege to work with your children. And it takes a lot of work, as we always tell you. But nights like this makes it all worthwhile. You'll hear some children singing that you didn't know could sing. There'll be some other little surprises that you didn't know could happen here at Abundant Life. So we ask you to sit back, relax, and remember, the light is come.
This year, the students and faculty of Abundant Life Christian Academy want you to know that Jesus is the light of the world. No longer will we place him in a manger, for right this moment, he is our high priest in the heavenly sanctuary, ministering and preparing a place for you and me. Very soon he will return as King of Kings and as Lord of Lords. We must get ready and reflect the light of his love so that the world can know him as well.
You know, it doesn't matter how old or how young you are. God can still use you to spread his word and light the world. The world is looking for someone, somewhere to share his light. We are God's children. It is our responsibility to share God's love and light the world. The world is looking for I don't know about you, but I love the Lord, and I'm going to walk in the light and let my little light shine.
Thank you.
Jesus came into the world to be the light, so people blinded by darkness could receive their sight. We were once lost in sin, until one glorious day when Jesus' light shone in and washed our sins away. Since Jesus' light came into our hearts to shine, his word has become alive while we commune with him and dine. As we walk in the light of Jesus, the world becomes so dim. We just want to have more light and be closer and closer to him. While walking in his light, Jesus gives us joy that overflows. He makes our hearts so happy that even our faces glow. The wondrous light of Jesus, what a marvelous thing. It makes us full of joy unspeakable and makes us want to sing. So go, share your faith, hold it high, shine the light.
Thank you.
Where are the lamps and lights placed in your house? Are they hidden away so none can see them? Or are they put in places where they shine brightly, giving sight to those in the room? The gospel of Jesus is the light we need. Through him, we no longer live in darkness. He not only gives us salvation, but also the love, the hope, and the power to shine our light. We shine our light by loving people and sharing the gospel with them. In the Sermon on the Mount, Jesus spoke to the crowd saying that God's people are the light of the world. God's people are charged with spreading the light and love of God to others. We carry this responsibility to illuminate this sin-darkened world. Matthew chapter 5, verses 14 through 16 reads, "You are the light of the world. A town built on a hill cannot be hidden. Neither do people light a lamp and put it under a bowl. Instead, they put it on its stand, and it gives light to everyone in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before others, that they may see your good deeds and glorify your Father in heaven. So I admonish you, hold up the light."
To be alive, be alive, just like a flame burning bright, lighting the night. The dark night has
more of the light.
Are you The world is so full of darkness, so we have to take a stand. Take a stand. If your brother slips down and falls, give him a helping hand, a good hand.
Let your light shine around the world, my brother. Let your light shine around the world, my sister. Let your light shine around the world, everybody. Let your light shine.
Sin-darkened world, and all of us are in dire need of the light of our Savior. As we read God's word, we take his light into ourselves. When we share what we have learned with others and demonstrate the love of God, we are shining out the light that we have taken in. We must be willing to use the amazing gifts and opportunities God has gifted us with and go light your world. Thank you.
Jesus, the light of the world, how dark the world without him would be.
Darkness is spread on land and sea.
The hope of the world rests alone with thee.
There will be shadows forever and always.
But soon the sun chases the shadows away.
Jesus will help me with this life, come what may.
Jesus is the light of the world today.
Stars shine in the heavens, but don't show the way.
So pure and shining in the heavens so bright.
Pitch black with little speckles of white.
A beautiful setting, a wonderful sight, but
Jesus is the real and only true light.
Amen. He is the light that shines night and day.
Nothing, not even a cloud, can take him away.
His light will shine whenever we say. Wait, his light will shine brighter whenever we say, with all of our hearts, that Jesus is the light of the world today.
in a dark room. A single light can illuminate enough for a human eye to see. Add multiple lights and it's even easier to see. It is the same when being alive for God. We live in a very dark, sinful world, and God is calling for people to rise up and become shining lights for Him. The more people accept the fact that they are called by God to shine brightly for Him and to live for Him, the more people will be reached with the good news of Jesus Christ. You can shine for Jesus because He has shined for you. Shine, Jesus, shine.
Send forth your word, Lord, and let them be light.
Amen, everyone.
Amen.
Do you feel blessed?
Amen.
All I know, I do. Now, we live in the entertainment capital of the world. And these little ones have wooed us. They have blessed us with the talents that God has given them. And the scripture tells us that we should train up a child in the way that he or she should grow, that when they get older, they will not depart from it. And so we see these little children letting their light shine. And right across this city, the city of lights, the city of entertainment, we have men and women that is using their monies, and they're dropping their monies into a black hole. Do you agree with me? Do you agree with me? All right. But you are wise, we are wise, and we decided that we will come to this event and we will use our money in a wise way. Now I understand, I've been checking certain average ticket prices of shows and so forth, and I've seen as low as $20 and as high as $500, and some of you may know even much more than I. And so I have been given the task right now to encourage you to contribute the minimum equivalent of a show that you will go to in town. Now, most of us Christians, we don't go to the shows, right? Unless they are family-centered shows. But even so, you have to pay a little for that, right? And so I want to encourage you to drop a soft donation to help in the efforts that we have here of the school educating our children and providing these programs, wholesome programs for you. And so we are going to be passing the offering baskets. It's going to be, you could just hand one over. Do we have others helping? And we're asking you to drop a soft donation. You know what I mean, a soft donation. Try not to let it jingle, but if that's all you have, that's all right. Amen? Amen. So, but drop us soft donations. The higher the denomination, the better it is. And we want to thank you in advance. And if you have a check, you could write the check out to the Abundant Life Christian Academy. And we will make sure we will put it to good use. Amen? Amen. Amen. And after you have lifted this offering, I will pray for the offering and for those that gave. Now, we just have to slow it down a little bit. There are certain individuals that's getting the denominations ready at the front. All right. If you have been passed and over here, just send a bucket inside the, send it right through. Send it right through. Yes. Send it, brother. Send it right through again. Yes. All right. Very good. Very good. Very good. All right. Amen. Amen. Have everyone been served? Just pass it on to the next pew for me, please. Pass it on to the other pew behind you. And just pass it along. Yes. That's right. That's right. Amen. Amen. Okay. All right. Have we ignored anyone? Is there anyone else? We want to make sure. All right. Just bring the offerings front to the front, please. Thank you very much. Thank you. You could place them here. Now, everyone, I'd like you to know that it takes a lot to have Christian education nowadays. And it's truly an honor to be a part of this institution. where we can educate our children for time and eternity. And we want to thank you for your donations. We want to thank you for your yearly support, your annual support, monthly support. We need help at this school here. You may have a gift that can help the school. You may not be able to give a financial blessing, but you could give of your time. We want to welcome you. Speak to any of the administrators, teachers at the school. We'll be happy to utilize your gift. Let us pray as we have collected this offering. Father, we thank you for the gifts that we have received. We pray that you bless the efforts that it will go to. And we ask that you bless the givers and those that did not have to give. We pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you.
Now know that Jesus is the light of the world. No matter where we go, we find hurting, lonely people who don't know Christ. We each must do our part to share God's light. And after we've done all we can, we will be able to look up and see Jesus, the light of this world, bursting through the sky, coming to take us home. It won't be long, so hold on and be encouraged. Do not get weary, because in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, he that shall come will come and will not tarry. Yes, the light is come.
To Ecuador, from Paris to Singapore, he is the Lord God, our King. The light is come.
Starving in people in America, we are his hands to share. The light has come.
It's the light of the world. It is the light.
The light is come.
That gives us his grace. light of the world. He is the light.
The light has come.
He is the light. Light of the world. He is the light. He is the light. Light of the world. He is the light.
All come, let us adore him.
He is the light, light of the world. He is the light. He is the light,
light of the world.
He is the light. He is the light. He is the light.
Because she may be hiding. But Miss Bernal, we have two Bernals. Both of those ladies made all those skirts for those girls, and they made all these bow ties and cummerbunds for the boys. Let's give them a hearty hand. Thank you so, so much. We couldn't do this without our awesome audio team back there recording, making sure the mics are in place and everything's on cue, so let's give them a hand. The children, you know I love you. I am very, very, very proud of you. And I know that heaven is shining on you because you let your little light shine. And we ask now that you will just bow your heads, and Ms. Johnson is going to give us the closing prayer.
Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for another opportunity to sing praises to your name. You've given us so much, and what little we can give back to you, we want to give it to you with our whole hearts. Please be with us as we travel home this evening. We thank you for all your many blessings, and we ask that you bring the students back tomorrow for one more day of school before the weekend. We love you and we thank you so much. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
And I just want you to give another hand, my pastor. He's a true pastor. He not only gives encouraging words and share God's word with us, but you know that this man